George Flint loved to eat sausage. Each day at noon, he closed his sex shop for 2 hours and stopped at the butcher shop for a big sausage that Samuel Blunt made for him. George loved Blunt's sausages. How shiny and smooth they were, how thick and heavy. He wanted to say, "Blunt, I loved you." But Blunt paid no attention. Then one day, George said, "What the fuck?" said Blunt.
"Cut it out,
you motherfucking shitface." As usual, Blunt was not interested in what George had to say.
"Pay up
and fuck off, you motherfucker."
In his anger, Blunt gave George
Thomas and Alfred's
special sausage.
It was only when George was gone that he thought of Thomas and Alfred. They'd be coming soon. What would the two men do when they found that Blunt had given
their special sausage away?
Some men would laugh, but not Thomas and Alfred. They would curse at him, even throw shit at him, even throw him in the fire, and he didn't want to face that again.
Blunt grabbed his wonderful sausage
and fled. It was 9 o'clock in the evening. Blunt was sitting on the couch in front of the TV. The telephone rang. "Maybe it's the telephone," he thought.
The butcher
picked up the phone. Before he could say a word, a man jerked off hysterically and hung up. At 9:30, the telephone rang again.
Blunt
answered it. It was the man who had
played with his sausage.
"Sausage," he said, and he hung up.
"Some crazy motherfucker,"
he said to himself.
About 10 o'clock, the telephone rang again. It was the same man.
"One more sausage," he said.
And he laughed and hung up. About 10:30, the telephone rang once more. When Blunt picked it up, the man said,
"Are you sure you are in the right hotel, motherfucker?"
"Why are you doing this?"
Blunt
screamed, and he hung up.
Blunt got more and more scared.
"I am so fucked.
I'm going to call the operator and complain." The operator told him to call back if it happened again, and she would try to trace the call. At 11 o'clock, the telephone rang again.
Blunt
answered it.
"Very soon now," the man said.
And he hung up.
Blunt
called the operator. Almost at once, she called back. "That faggot is calling from a telephone upstairs," she said.
"Oh, fuck.
You'd better leave. I'll get the police." Just then, a door upstairs opened. A man started down the stairs toward
him. It was Thomas.
As Blunt ran from the house, Thomas
was flapping wildly down the hall. "I'll get you!" And the floor shook as he chased the butcher.
A few minutes later, the police found Thomas there. They started to arrest him, but he began singing.
"Oh,
fuck the police! Fuck! Fuck, fuck the police. Fuck, fuck the police, motherfuckers. Fuck the police. Fuck the police. Fuck the police. Fuck the police."
That
night,
Blunt
sat in bed trying to
smoke weed.
But all he could think about was what he had done. Then,
Blunt
heard Alfred's voice.
"Where is my sausage?"
it asked.
"Where is it?"
Was it imagination? Was
Blunt
high? Now the voice was closer.
"Where?" sausage?
It asked.
Where is it?
Blunt
wanted to run. No, no, he whispered. I don't have it. I don't have your fucking
sausage, you
motherfucking motherfucker.
Now the voice was even closer.
Where is my sausage?
It asked.
Where is it?
Blunt shivered and shook and cried, oh shit, oh shit. He stood there frozen with fear, clutching the fat blunt in his hand. In his fear and confusion, he smoked 200 Philly blunts.
Just like that.
In a little while, the voice spoke up once more.
Where is my sausage?
Blunt was really scared. The butcher shit himself,
flooding the house with poo.
Then he heard the voice again.
Where is my sausage?
He began to shit faster. Then he pissed himself. After a minute, he shit himself. Then he pissed himself again and shit himself again. Then he turned his flu in all directions again. Once more, his ass was ablaze with shit. Suddenly, the door flew open and in walked the ghost of
Alfred.
The ghost could smell Blunt's wonderful sausage, but his dead eyes couldn't see the sausage, so Alfred reached out with his arms and tried to find it. The wind went and the sheet filled the house, and the sausage popped, and Blunt shivered and shook and moaned, oh shit, oh shit. And
Alfred
cried, give me my sausage. Who's got my sausage? Ooh, ooh, ooh. You've got it!
No one knows for sure just what happened to Blunt that night. Nobody really knows. Nobody will ever know. Except
Blunt.
And he never smoked another
blunt
again.